ball security will come into play as both teams will have to deal with some very slippery conditions.
It's the Saints going up against the Packers.
With that, let's welcome in our fine broadcast team. We are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
This place first opened way back in 1957. We are inside legendary Lambeau Field here in Green Bay. No team means more to a city than the Packers to Green Bay. And this was the scene a few moments ago as the green and gold made their way out of the historic tunnel. They're ready to go as they get set to match up with the New Orleans Saints. Along with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, we look at this Packer team as we enter play here. They've been playing their best football of the year, winners of four in a row.
And if you look back to last week, it was all about their defense. Anytime you hold an NFL team to single digits, that's saying something.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Saints, they too were winners last time out, so something's got to give here.
And I love it when both teams come in off of wins. Great mindsets, and it usually leads to a really well-played game.
On the return, it's Ted Ginn Jr. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Here come the Saints for their opening drive. Leading him out, one of the all-time greats. Hard to believe in his 17th season now, Drew Brees.
Okay, I'm not taking a turn to negative town, even though it's going to sound like it. The two interceptions he threw last week, those obviously have to be eliminated, and that was the focus of practice this week. But let's face it, he did throw three touchdown passes.
And they got the win.
So I think it was a good week for him to work on things. Had some positives, the win being first and foremost. Now he's just got to eliminate those interceptions.
23 yards on the play.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
And a very good offensive unit here. One of the reasons they're so good is running back Mark Ingram.
Took a little while for him to find his footing when he got into the league, but the former Heisman Trophy winner has it now and has really upped his pass receiving potential. A nice player.
See if they stay on the ground for second down. Ingram again. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down. And let's get a look at the Green Bay defense.
Mike Daniels is often underrated as a big-time defensive player in the NFL, but the Packers know his value. Short in stature, but that leverage advantage that he has allows him to get upfield, get underneath offensive blockers, and make plays in the backfield. In addition, very strong at the point of attack. A big-time weightlifter, got that from his dad, a former power lifter.
And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here.
Neutral zone infraction, defense.
So they jumped on the left side of that line.
And you know, when you're at the end spot, you are like in the starting blocks, waiting for the pistol to fire and go, and he jumped a little bit too early.
After the penalty is Ingram. And he's got room. And he'll be out of bounds, able to take this one down to the 20-yard line. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been four down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, though, if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said, go for it.
To throw is Brees. It's complete. Flaner, right side. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the one. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18.
Brandon, lest my eyes deceive me, I think they found a matchup that they're trying to exploit here, don't you? I mean, it's the second time they've gone to him here on this drive.
Yeah, opening drive. It's a tone setter, right? I think they're going to be looking his way a lot.
Yeah, and I think that the way things are going right now, they like him as a featured receiver. Let's see what kind of adjustments the defense is going to make to try and take that away.
And again, it's Ingram, and he is in for the score. Touchdown, New Orleans. third touchdown now on the year. And the Saints have taken the early lead. That's just a solid, methodical drive to start this game.
And how about how it culminated? Doing exactly what they wanted to do, getting the ball downfield, and then running it into the end zone. I'm just telling you, partner, when you run it in rather than throw it in, that hurts a defense psychologically a heck of a lot more.
And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he's simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. So here comes the Packers offense now onto the field. They'll be led out by their highly decorated quarterback, Aaron Rodgers.
Well, he did go 2-2 in the last ball game. Well, actually, he went 2-2-1, with the one being the victory.
Yeah.
That's the bottom line there. But wasn't it funny at practice? He threw one when we were watching through an interception, and the defense got on him a little bit good-naturedly, but they're letting him know, you got to cut down those interceptions. We can't bail you out all the time.
Yeah, two touchdowns, two picks, but as you said, they got the win in that effort last week. And this first play will get him back to the 25, but that's going to be it. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. And the big boys up front in the trenches, what do you think of the O-line, Charles?
I love them because this is a group that's so cohesive. They know what the man next to them is going to do at all times, and they operate as a terrific unit.
Here to his running back, and he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. Pretty good running there, 9 yards, sets up a third and one.
That was a good run, probably right on the edge of breaking into something really big. So the defensive guys right now are talking about, okay, what can we do to slow him down before he truly gets started?
And he'll give it here to his running back, and he will have a first down here at about the 40. Here on first down, and he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time they were able to get in there and influence the throw, and remember, quarterback's got to get rid of it. They don't have the tucker rule that they can fall back on anymore.
He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete, and he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down. So they'll give a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we've hit the end of quarter one. 7-0 is our score. EA Sports NFL Sunday returns following this.
The NFL on EA Sports is fueled by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. Second quarter about to get underway with the Packers in possession of the football, but they've got a third and inches coming up, trying to keep the chains moving. And again, this time to the tailback. And he has the first down yardage before they bring him down right at the 45. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well. They go play action here on first down. And he completes it to Jordy Nelson. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line. 23 yards on the play. Now a handoff here to his running back. He'll get it inside the red zone, but only for a couple, down to the 19.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
No, he doesn't have it. Maybe some alligator arms there going over the middle. 3rd down. fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously, one that should have been caught. They've got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
And he has the first down before he's tackled at the five. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. We're back to Lambeau following these words. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll pay a visit to Larry Ridley in Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report. And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on. They'll give it to him right up the gun. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Green Bay touchdown. A great play there with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Packers are within an extra point of tying this thing up. And that moment we just saw, always so special for any rookie, the first touchdown of his career.
And there's nothing like anticipation, is there? You know he's been dreaming about it, thinking about it. It's been a part of every bit of his being. And finally, it gets done. He's got to feel great right now.
Crosby on now to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Packer defense getting set to go again. And despite being down on the scoreboard, this unit, they've had some big-time hits.
Sort of like us at practice the other day. I saw you take a running start at that blocking sled. You took it down.
Bounced off like a rubber band.
No, not at all. But you're exactly right. They are doing their job, but they want to add takeaways to it. You need to have more of those to go along with the big hits we're seeing.
By the way, when I tried that and I bounced back, I noticed that you laughed with everyone else. You didn't try to get in my corner.
No. Someone had just told me a joke on the other side.
Right,
I missed
right.
it. Totally missed it.
He was trying to get it to his running back, Alvin Kamara. And it's second down.
Well, they're slinging it. And then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
That came in hot, but overthrown, out of his reach and incomplete. He dumps it down to Ingram. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and that'll bring up a third down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
From the gun on third down, Breeze. Over the middle, open is Thomas. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. Breeze on the hook up to Thomas for the New Orleans first.
And that's understanding where the markers are, because it's not just running to them. Because on the catch, you can actually be pushed back.
And it's a fumble, and the Packers pick it up. And they'll set up shop in enemy territory at the 45-yard line. Charles, he lost a fumble last week as well. So now back-to-back weeks, maybe you expect that from your tailback, but not him.
You're exactly right, because you work a lot with your running backs about how they have to protect the ball in traffic. But downfield in open space, that's dangerous as well, because you may make someone miss, and their flailing hand can knock the ball away if you don't tuck it away.
And he's brought down, but not before reaching the 8-yard line. That one goes for 36 yards. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. A great effort there. With two touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Packers are able to cash in for 6.
And while that touchdown does not give them an insurmountable lead, It's still a lead, and that always feels good to a team.
They'd love to take that into the lockers, but a little time left up. And oh, it's blocked. Crosby on now to kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. A reminder later tonight, a game some folks have had circled on their calendar since the schedule came out in April. That's the Super Bowl rematch. Falcons, Charles, at Foxborough to take on the Patriots.
Super Bowl 51 and a half, anyone?
Then on Monday night, that's no slouch either. An NFC East battle between the Redskins and the Eagles. Kobe Fleener, the tight end, his intended target. And that'll bring up second down. Shotgun now for Breeze. Now this is a catch by Ted Ginn. And prior to this third and two play, we're going to get a timeout call as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this first half. Breeze looking to throw on third and two. And Ginn's got it. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two, as the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number two. Breeze now on first down. And some space here. And he'll avoid the tackle there with a slide. That one goes for 24 yards. First down now, but that clock rolling. Breeze now on first down. He goes underneath to Ingram. Touchdown, New Orleans. Mark Ingram in the final seconds of the first half. And the Saints are able to cash in for six.
Well, someone has a sense of the dramatic here, don't they? Scoring this late in the half to take the lead going into the locker room.
Now they just don't want to misstep misfortune on the next kickoff because there's still a little bit of time left on that clock.
Yeah, you do have to bring that up, don't you? In the NFL, every play is critical. And if you give up something cheap there, all that advantage they just gained goes right out the window.
And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half. A final shot before half for Rodgers. And he's taken down here by the Saints. So we have reached halftime with the visiting Saints out on top. As we'll send you down to Orlando as we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to our EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. The Packers haven't played their best football and trail because of it. The Saints have looked good on the road and will just try to keep the ball rolling in the second half. All right, let's roll those highlights. Saints with possession halfway through one. Ingram's going to use a stiff arm to get away, and he'll go in for a score. That puts them up by a touchdown. Packers on offense midway through the second. He'll cut it off the left side this time, and he cap off the long drive with a touchdown. The Packers trail now by one. Now first and 10. Thomas is going to make the catch, but fumble here. Offense on the field now after the fumble. He'll throw it to the left side on the run, and he'll take it in for the touch. They go ahead by five. First and 10. Ingram's got nobody around him on the catch. It ends up working for a touchdown. The Saints up now by two. So that'll wrap it up for us here at the EA Sports Studio. We'll head back now to Green Bay for the start of the second half.
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. There again is the running back as he trots onto the field. And he's found the end zone twice, and now I'm guessing he's thinking, hey, let's find it three times.
And you got to figure from the defensive perspective, how has he gotten there twice? What are we going to do to keep him out for a third time? How do we tighten things down? Because he and his offensive mates, they are really in sync right now.
Now Rodgers on the bootleg. And his throw's going to be incomplete. Well, too much oomph, too much mustard there on that pass.
They really turned it loose, didn't they? Really cut loose with that one. Sharp, strong. Didn't lead to a completion, though. Made it very difficult.
On play action. Now Rodgers. Incomplete, almost intercepted. They haven't picked him off yet. Would have been a great time for the first, but instead it's third down.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play, right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense if that fell harmlessly to the ground. Open man, the tight end, Rodgers. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. The Rodgers to Rodgers connection, good for a Packer first down.
When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
And not much running room. Down to the 32. A gain of three, second down. And quickly, they get to the line. On play action, it's Rodgers. And he finds a man with a crossing route. And he carries this one all the way down to the nine. 23 yards on the play. Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he'll take this from the 9 down to about the 7.
Well, it's been the air game that's taken them down on this drive before they finally turned around and handed it off on the last play.
And now they're looking for the big boys to get him in the end zone. Couldn't do it there.
It'll be interesting to see. Offensive line's had to pass block a lot on this drive. Will they be able to revert and fire out and create some space in the run game?
A nice run there as he picks up 6. It's going to be 3rd and goal now. They'll give it to him right up the gun. And he'll take this one in for a Packer touchdown. A great play there. His 3rd touchdown of the season, all coming in this game. And the Packers are able to cash in for 6. He's got the hat trick now of rushing touchdowns. Also has his team the advantage.
And I'm looking at it two ways here. If I'm on defense, I don't care what they do now. I commit as many people as it takes to slowing him down running the football. Even if they want to hit me over the top on play action, I just don't let him beat me that way anymore. And if I'm him, I'm in the huddle calling the plays myself. I don't care what play call comes in. I tell my quarterback, guess what? You're handing it to me again.
And if I'm the quarterback, I'm saying, okay, that sounds good, right?
Smart quarterback.
Crosby on now to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
Breeze again here on 2nd and 10. Left side and caught by Flaner. That catch good for 5. It's 3rd down.
I think it's okay there. They didn't get a whole lot on that play, but it's nice to have a safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
Here's Breeze to throw. Oh, look at Thomas, wide open. And he will finally go out of bounds, but not before he takes it down to the 25. A big play for the Saints on third down. 45 yards.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that and have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
Going forward pass, offense.
So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
On second down, Ingram. And a pretty little juke move there on a nice game. Give him nine there. They still need six more now on third down. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we've played three quarters. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Elsewhere, a third quarter score. And you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. Mitch Trubisky, a single touchdown pass to this point in that one. One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. From the gun, it's Breeze. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. Just a five-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down. He got out of bounds. That's a good thing, but still short of the first.
And now, since this brings up fourth down, the defensive play caller, grab your nerves, because now you don't want to be so amped up that you give them a first down by getting out of your lanes, but you also don't want to just lay back and let them have it easily.
But he will have the first down before he's tackled at the 12. A gain of four on the play, and they're able to convert here on fourth and inches. The offense certainly looking to score some points, but they also need ball security here late as we get down to the final moments of this one. On first and 10, here's Breeze. This will be caught at about the 5. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. Breeze to throw on second down. Incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield. Let's get the call.
Holding offense.
Umpire threw the flag, usually always indicates holding, and that's what we've got.
And you know, depending on their positioning, where you are on the field, the umpires get different responsibilities, but always, always making sure no one's holding.
Breeze gives it up to Ingram, and he's not even going to get back to the line of scrimmage. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
And as we've seen throughout this season, it's no picnic trying to score touchdowns against this unit. They're ranked number 1 against the run. It's also difficult because it's not easy to throw the ball against him either.
Now Breeze. That's caught. It's Thomas. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Michael Thomas, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Saints have moved out in front here in the fourth quarter. Coming into the year, Breeze, 465 touchdown passes, add another one to the total.
You know, it's funny, I just talked with his college head coach, and he told me that when Drew was a sophomore at Purdue, they weren't sure he was truly the starter, even though he started the opening game. He made a play early in that one, but the coach got on the headset and told the rest of the staff, well, fellas, we found our quarterback. Now we got to make sure we find the rest of our team.
Breeze hasn't looked back since. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The the Packer offense now ready to get back onto the field. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offense that's humming.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a three and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. They come up on a second down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down to the wire. Second down now after the incompletion. Now they try the right side here. And he got blown up on that play. Back at the 20. It's a loss of two, now third down. They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. He'll look to throw. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. So he was unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark, really, start to finish.
Yeah, it makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here, or is he just off just by a bit? Maybe get it back in this situation. He'll need to.
And no, it's incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And now possession's going to go over with a football at the 20-yard line. So now it may look bleak, but this one not over. They do have all three timeouts.
Even at this point of...
And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Hands to Ingram, and he'll get this one down to about the 27. Now a second timeout called for by the defense. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. The Saints on third down. They have been superb. 5 for 6 to this point. This is third and 17. Again, they'll run with Ingram. And he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. Now the defense will burn their third and final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. So the defense had a chance to catch their breath, and now they're back out and ready. So a big one coming now for Will Lutz. This a 43-yard attempt. And Lutz's kick is good. And the drive will wind up yielding three. So they get the three here, but you wonder whether that's going to be enough.
Yeah, I mean, you've now made it so they need a touchdown rather than a field goal to catch them. But you're right. If they'd gotten six out of that drive, this would be a much different game.
The Saints defense getting ready here, heading back onto the field. And they're just trying to keep him out of the end zone. Obviously, a field goal does no good in this situation. So what's the appropriate amount of pressure defensively, Charles?
I think he's had a little more pressure than what is normal. If you normally want to send a three-man rush, maybe you make it four. If it's four, maybe you make it five. Anything to make sure that he can't just sit back there all day and find a target. And then you tell your secondary, play your normal coverage, and maybe an extra step or two back.
Yeah, be careful that nothing goes over the top. They'll look to throw, and his throw's going to be incomplete. Randall Cobb, the intended receiver, and now it's second down. I guess you can't be afraid to take those chances late in the game. He tried to fit that one in there. Nice job, though, defensively.
But to your point, it was a nice job of knocking the ball away. But you're also right. You can't be afraid to take those chances. That means your guy's going downfield to catch the ball. They've got to elevate their game and come down with these in order to keep your offense moving.
Give them 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs. Back to throw. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
That would have been a great catch, but it's really difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
He's back to throw. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15. A good pick up there of 20 yards. Back to throw. And this is caught. Touchdown. And now they're an extra point away from winning this thing in the final seconds.
Well, that's the one they had to have. Put them in a position where they're tied up, but I got to get out of the way. We still got an extra point that's pretty crucial.
That's right. Just one more element to complete the victory. They have gone to the fourth quarter, by the way, in that game in Cleveland. And the Browns, they've surged back to take the lead there. DeShone Kizer, outstanding to this point. Four touchdown passes. Extra point try now for Crosby. And it's no good. He missed it. And the game remains tied. Oh, boy. So here comes the kickoff now. All even here in this fourth quarter. This will be fielded at the 6. And he'll have good starting field position as he's up just shy of the 40. Left side here. And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. And now they're going to get the timeout. A huge play. Has him in field goal range with a chance to win. So it all rests now on the right leg of Will Lutz. Footing obviously an issue in the driving rain. This one for the win. And his kick is good. Despite the rainstorm, a good snap, a good hold, and the kick went through. Checking the NFL scoreboard there in the fourth now in Minneapolis. And not much trouble in that game for the Vikings. They've opened their lead further. Sam Bradford with one touchdown pass thus far. Well, Charles, the forecast called for rain throughout the entire game, and we got rain throughout the entire game, but these two teams, they had fun getting dirty out there. They love the slop.
Did you trust the forecast ahead of time? Are you one of those guys that's skeptical about it, or did you trust it?
But when I saw just a big blob of green on the radar, I said, okay, let's trust.
Yeah, and that's why I'm glad you took my advice. Got your notes laminated, because, you know, open-air booth, that rain can affect us as well, although not as much as the guys on the field. But let's face it, it's kind of fun to watch these types of games, isn't it?
It is. By the way, how impressive is it that you travel with a laminator? I didn't even know there was a portable laminator.
The things that you learn.
Golly, wise beyond his years. So for New Orleans, they climb back to 500 now at 3 up and 3 down. And they'll head back home next week to take on the Chicago Bears. Meanwhile, for the Packers, they drop just their second game so far as they fall